Hi everyone, my name is Chantel and welcome to another video. It is the first Friday of the month of August, my birth month, and today I'm creating the 6th Harry Potter Matchbox Diorama for you. If you would like to catch up on all the other ones, I will leave a link in the iCard section. So let's see what the 6th Harry Potter Matchbox Diorama will be. Let's see what we get. And the 6th one will be the Gryffindor Common Room. So let's get started. As with the previous matchboxes in this series, I create these myself using a template. There is a link in the description box below along with the measurements that I use. If you would like to know what kind of materials I use, there is an Amazon store link in the description box as well, which will take you to many useful lists if you would like to purchase any materials. The Gryffindor Common Room, a very highly requested video, and yes, all the other common rooms are also in the prompt box. Next year I'm going to create 1/12th scale common rooms, and you can participate by sending in a creation or supplies to go in the common rooms. I will leave a link to the community post below. But let's talk about the matchbox diorama I'm creating here. This one has a very, very long, ugly stage, but I promise you, it will be okay in the end. As you can see, I've sketched out all the elements that I need to cut out. Once that is done, I gently cut out all the windows and arches. Because I wanted to make the actual staircase to the dormitories, I had to add an extra wall to the back of the matchbox. As you can see, this adds just that little extra dimension. I then draw in where I want the windows to be and cut them out with my craft knife. Then onto the staircase. I have made these throughout this series from this thick cardboard, and it's no different for this diorama. I did struggle a little putting this one together. I wanted to build it onto the diorama, but I ended up taking it off as it wasn't going to end up in the archway. So I built it and then put it onto the diorama, and that worked fine. I also added the landing and the railing. Before I glue on the curved back wall, I cut out the windows that are on the side of the diorama. Now we're getting to the interesting part. Here you can see me painting on the tapestry. That is going to change later in the video. I also added the bricks just on the brown wall and this archway. This archway is gonna stay around the window, but the brick wall is gonna change as well. Now adding on some windows with some acetate. I'm putting my measurements on the acetate with permanent marker, as you can easily remove any excess with some rubbing alcohol. And here I'm gluing on the windows. The glue that I used for this video is mainly Fabri-Tac glue, which is the clear glue. And to put the furniture into the common room, I used super glue. And finally, after making the window, I am putting on the curved wall to the back of the matchbox. Now, of course, we have to put a top and a bottom to the curved wall. So by placing a piece of card against it, tracing around the curve, cutting that out and gluing it on, you get the perfect measurements. This is the floor, which I'm painting with brown watercolor paint, and then going over it again to add in the details. And now it's time to close up the box. You must have noticed I kept the diorama a secret in my thumbnail and video title. I got a comment from one of you that it will add a little bit of mystery if I keep it a secret to start with. After a week, I'll change it to the normal title and thumbnail, but to start, you won't know which one of the scrolls I will open, which adds a little bit more magic to these videos. Here I am covering the side window with some acetate and basically using the same technique. The cover of this diorama opens on the other side than all the other ones I've done so far. This is because this way I can create more of a room with the fireplace sitting on the right hand side. And this is the moment where I think, yeah, I'm not happy with that tapestry. So let's add some fabric. Again, I use Fabri-Tac glue here, but with Fabri-Tac glue, you have to be very careful that it's, yes, it's for fabric, but if you use too much of it, it will seep through your fabric. So you have to kind of put it on and then spread it out. And that's what I'm doing. And as the glue is drying, as this glue dries very fast, I kind of push the top side down with tweezers. You can also use a needle or a toothpick for this, just to give it that tapestry look. I then go in with some soft pastels to give the tapestry a more muted and matte look and add some more color. From some cardboard, I cut out these little frames. I color them with a gold metallic pen and glue watercolor paper to the back of them. I didn't add much detail to these paintings, but I do think they give the desired effect. From some cardboard and beads, I created these tiny little chairs and a couch. I painted them with acrylic paints. Then onto the fireplace, from a piece of cardboard, I cut out this shape, and the offcuts from the side are perfect for the slanted effect that this fireplace has. Then this is the part where the whole look changes. I kept thinking there's something wrong with the look of this room, but I had all the elements there. And then I decided to paint the entire wall gray. And that is what fixed the look of this room. As you're looking at this, I will tell you something about a little poll that I put up recently. As you all know, I'm working on Hagrid's Hut and part 2 is coming out next week. The poll is on my community page and I will leave a link below. The poll is about the next 1/12th scale Harry Potter diorama, which I want to start in September. And I would love for you to vote. Going back to the diorama, this is where I built a little cabinet that you can see in the common room. I built it from cardboard and cardstock and painting it brown with acrylic paint. Here I'm placing all the furniture in, but let's have a look at the final result, as there might be a little surprise there. And this is it for the 6th Harry Potter Matchbox Diorama. If you liked it, please give this video a thumbs up, it really helps my channel out. Make sure to check out my socials and consider supporting me on Patreon. And if you're new here, welcome! Please don't forget you can click the subscribe button to become part of the Raven family. Thanks so much for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye!